Hey, Rhete!
Hello?
You know what game's really cool?
Contra Hardcore?
Yeah.
Because the title screen already said
yeah, that.
Or the credits.
The credit thingy gave it away. Real quick, like. So yeah, I did a run of this game earlier today, and I forgot to turn on all of the audio!
Oh, dear.
So
okay, I'll just be your guy doing sound like...
Okay, and I'll do the music, so...
Let's go!
There you go.
I forget what he says.
Oh, hi, Rhete.
Okay.
So, this game is really awesome.
Yes.
It is one of my favorite games of all time. This is a game that I could go back to and play on any given day and probably still just beat it.
Any given day that ends with Y.
Yeah, any given day that
ends with Contra.
Yeah, it's got to be a day that ends in Y, though. But you know, like, replaying this game and thinking more about how game engines work, I came to a realization that this game ain't give no fucks about sprite limits.
Really?
Yeah, because it is not afraid to just, like, throw billions and billions of, like, particles, or just pieces of things and debris and explosions all over the place, and, like, those things are just glitching the hell out because it's just, like, the Genesis can't do it, but they're covering it up really well. With
by
all
doing
of the,
like,
yeah, just by
kind of like on and off frames.
Yeah, yeah, and you'll see like a lot of sprites kind of just like have lines in them because they're being undrawn and stuff. It's really interesting.
This guy's got some interesting rotation on him.
Yeah, I'm just standing there chilling.
Yeah. It's one of those things like when this came out, it's just like, oh, I didn't think Genesis could do effects like that.
Yeah,
like because people thought rotation was just a Mode 7 thing, even though it's actually kind of a background effect in SNES.
Yeah, yeah, it's. It's very similar to what Mode 7 does.
Yeah, but I don't actually know how they do that stuff on a Genesis.
Not at all.
Because very few games, actually.
That was a real dumb joke. I don't know why I took that one.
You made it.
I made it, but it was just like, looking at it, I was like, why did I do that? That was an awful word. You'll see a lot of that in me kind of fumbling with controls.
There's a lot of stuff blowing up in this game.
Yeah, you don't realize how much things explode until you're looking back at video of having seen the game.
The whole city's just on fire.
Yeah, it's just like, just blow everything up.
And even the cars right there just blow up.
Yeah, it's just, why not? There should just be explosions going on nonstop for no reason. Like, I have a feeling like Vlander would love this game with the amount of explosions and screen shake it
has. I'm pretty sure he would have. Like at some point. The building is exploding.
I love that they just carved the building down nice and neat.
That is weird. I've never really noticed that. Like, for what reason does that happen?
Because we fucking can. So what am I going to do, Rhete? What do you think?
I think you're going back to the facility.
Because
you told me which route you're doing.
Damn! Oh, there's a swear on a 16-bit game, by the way. That was rare.
I was correct. It is Research Center.
Boom.
Played the European version of this that changes, like...
Everybody's robots, and it's real dumb.
They're still chasing the alien cell. It's, like, the script is totally different. It's really weird.
And they make Deadeye Joe more robot-y?
Yeah.
It's so dumb.
Does he actually even talk in that version?
I don't think so. I don't think they even mention there being anybody in the robot. I think he just kind of pops out.
Yeah. They might even, like, alter Stage 4 to have it always be the empty one.
Yeah. I like this boss here. It's kind of funny.
It just kills itself.
Yeah, it's real great.
I think there's something like that in Rocket Knight Adventures, too, where...
Well, I mean, the games share the same producer, and I think most of the same team.
Yeah, so. This was kind of the team on Konami that didn't split off to form Treasure.
Yeah. And then there's just like a... Contra 3 kind of remix boss, only he's very easy.
Oh, I don't know. He can be random, though.
Yeah, but he doesn't, like, have the sword attack or anything, so you just get inside the arc where he's swinging. That's it. And I'm waiting here, because I don't want the
What is even happening with the camera here?
I don't even know, but I'm waiting to get him destroyed so that I can fight this thing from the bottom of the screen, because that attack can just totally blindside you.
Interesting.
So I usually wait it out there for a cycle or two, just so I don't get fucked. Rats! You guys were saying damn just like a stage ago. Come on.
You're only allowed one damn in a PG-13 game. That's the rule. Actually, did this come out when Sega had like their own ratings?
Yeah, I think this was like GA 13. Or not GA, but MA 13?
No, this couldn't have been MA. I mean, I could check, but...
It was something 13, I think.
Probably GA 13.
GA 13.
GA 7.
Something like that.
Because this stuff, you know, you're not blowing heads off like Mortal Kombat.
Look how smaller the Doctor is compared to her.
Yeah, that's...
It's just real, kind of like, we didn't really go back and touch that up or anything.
And here we have the rare stage portion where...
Yeah, like where you actually run and gun through things. This is basically...
What is the physics on that jump?
I don't even know, but I love it. You jump out and back in. I like to pretend she's got rocket boots. And this is me trying to, like, pretend that that her crash bomb has some kind of use to just grab those capsules.
Wow.
That's a theme you might see throughout the course of this video, is me trying to find use for that damn thing, and it's just real useless. This is basically kind of like stage 3 of Contra 3, but...
Yeah, I noticed that. Like, even the level layout was...
Very similar.
Very similar to that first outdoor part, and then this boss looks very... But this boss is so dumb! It just makes, like, toys with the things.
Yeah, it just... And most of them are relatively harmless.
Yeah, that one wasn't even falling towards you.
Yeah, like, this one might catch you off guard if you're too low on the wall or something, but you can just, like, climb up and...
He's
deal.
Just like, I'm making toys. Oh, you broke my toys.
Oh, I'll get you this time. I'll get... Oh, yes.
I don't have enough HP to do the third one.
No more toys. Get out of here. What do they research here if that guy is the boss?
Aliens. I don't know.
I guess.
I mean, it's the hacker.
Kinda... Oh, yeah, Neumann Cascade. This goofy-looking prick.
The garbage dump.
Dump. Dump is such a great word, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just love it. Just say it.
Dump.
Dump. It's such a good word. Like, this is a really hard part of the stage.
Yeah.
These last two bikers are in perfect sync with the music.
What music?
Yeah. Exactly. There's another little runny gunny part.
Yeah, but this one can actually kill you.
Yeah,
because there's just so much explosions.
And, like, debris flying everywhere.
Yeah. So if you miss something, you won't notice because there's just so much stuff flying around.
It's just kind of a
Those guys, actually, they kind of look like Brownie, I just noticed.
Yeah, they do.
That's kind of sad.
Interesting. And there's, like, an awesome boss.
What is this, boss 10 already? I forgot to count.
This is, like, 13 or 14, I think. Yeah, I don't know if it comes through in the screen share quite as well, but, like, this guy's just got, like, parts of his sprites are disappearing all over the place.
Yeah, I kind
of
see that.
Because there's just so many. This game doesn't care. It's like, whatever.
I mean, a lot of NES games didn't care either. Like, they just, like... I remember on Mario 1, the NES game, like, thinking World 8 Bowser just had invisible hammers on purpose.
Oh, yeah, because
he would just throw so fucking many.
You can get sprite limited, and then the hitboxes exist. But the graphic, and I don't know what I'm doing in this section at all. I'm just like, what? What am I even doing? I doing? I was just like, whatever. I have no idea what was going through my head going through that.
It's a secret ending if you go up right there. That's not going to be shown off.
And it's a real good ending.
The entrance there kind of is like a Mega Man one, except you just blow the doors open.
Yeah. That's what Mega Man needed. More doors exploding.
The virtual zone!
Wah, wah, wah.
Because this is the 90s, and this is what people thought VR was like.
Yep. And here I go. I'm trying to make that crash bomb work for me. I'm giving it
Is it not that strong?
It's not that good, no.
Because, like, you normally in Contra games, like, that would be the strongest weapon by a huge margin.
Yeah, Ray has got one, and it's just completely balling, though.
Yeah.
Like, the only real power weapon Sheena has is her brake laser. This guy's kind of a PUD. He's got a penetrating weapon. Yeah, I said PUD! Welcome to third grade, PUD whackers. And guess what, boss? I don't much care for.
Gemini.
I don't like Gemini at all. He was given not a good pattern. That's just what I tell myself. And then, I don't know, blocks. Like, there's so many just real silly fucking bosses in this game.
So when I played this game, when did I forget when I first played this game, but it was profoundly influential for a lot of my games to come.
Oh, yeah.
So you can basically say, hey, it's Wrecking Ball.
Yeah. Like, quite literally.
Very much like the tank form and stuff and like the helicopter form. I was just thinking about this boss when making that.
You know what boss is real fun to fight with a pea shooter?
This one?
Boss. Real fun.
Yeah, because it's a lot of moving hitboxes that you're not aligned properly for.
You gotta do... Yeah. Coming up here, you're going to see me make a real... Like have to like correct myself on the fly because I'm stuck in like having my aim locked. And I'm like trying to get to my laser. And then I overshoot it and say, fuck it, just use the homing laser. Even though it takes way longer. And I don't like this thing being on the screen because... He can pee random and catch you off guard.
That is such a weird boss, though, where it's just like three zodiac sign bosses and then three cube thing bosses.
Cube thing! Man, we are already on stage four. This game just goes.
It goes, yeah.
It does not slow down for fucking anything. So.
I think it kind of makes sense that the first four would be... Well, actually, four isn't that short, though, but the first three are pretty short because... You want to get to, like, the splits and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Four has a very long boss for some reason.
And it's so good!
It's so good the first couple times. Then when you're replaying, it's just like, man, there's no way to rush this boss at all.
You know what else? You know what other thing, what other part of the game is real fun with a pea shooter?
Oh.
This.
Probably all of it really kind of sucks.
It's just a nightmare trying to keep all of that tame.
Yeah.
And then here's just more. Hey, look what we can do with segmented sprites. We're going to do more of them.
So in this run, do you do the fight against all the alien forms of these?
You'll just have to find out, won't you?
Because I actually thought that was really clever how the enemies in this stage actually kind of serve a purpose.
Yeah, they get combined. And then like the way they combine is also makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Isn't that new? Just kind of a doofy looking boss.
This is actually the stage 2 boss comeback.
This is just like, look, this like a lot of this game is really just like, look what we can do.
With, yeah, but like, it's awesome.
The weird physics on the platform is just kind of like being pulled up like that in a really smooth manner.
Not it was always something. Fun when I would just do stuff like that in Flash, even though it wasn't impressive anymore, but I'm just like, look, a boss made of balls.
I did it. He reacts to your shots.
What, did you shoot the dinosaur?
No,
oh.
No, there's the little rolly guys.
Yeah.
These guys can be annoying, too, if they catch you off guard, because sometimes they'll just fall right on your head.
Yeah.
And, achoo!
That's what I was thinking.
That's real funny. I don't know why they put that there. It's just,
yeah, just to kill you.
Yeah. Then here's my favorite
and then
boss.
The greatest boss.
Greatest boss ever. Just this guy. It's the happiest fucking boss I think you've ever seen in a video game.
Again, just a total case of look what we can do with rotation.
Yeah, look what we can do with all of this rotation and weird, like, movement and scaling and how smooth it can be.
Yeah.
Like, this guy does not have a care in the world. He's not trying to kill me. He's just he thinks I'm here to dance. Let's add another one. What does that do?
D clip there.
Yep. Boom, 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 boom.
There's two.
This is so stupid. I love this boss though. He's the absolute silliest thing. He just jumps around like a fucking idiot. He has a lot of attacks he can do, but they all seem pretty rare.
You typically kill him. Yeah, he's dead during that attack.
Later, dude. And there's like, you can't see it on that left rock there. Mm-hmm. There's some bad piling going on. They didn't get it piled properly. Just weird, dumb things you learn about a game playing it for 20 years.
Yeah.
And now we go into to my jam. This is the coolest shit.
So this one will have what's his face inside it because you didn't kill him in stage 2.
Yep.
It's Deadeye Joe.
Hey, I remember you. And it's just, look what we can do. This is very threatening.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not the hugest fan of the auto-scroll parts here.
Yeah, they're a little slower than they need to be. Could have been cut down quite a bit. But the whole theme of this boss is basically you are your own worst enemy.
Yeah.
Like, most people will just be gunning at this thing, but if you just control your fire, you're good to go.
Which kind of plays with the whole auto-scroller motif as well, where you want to go fast, but then he'll just fuck you over if you keep shooting.
Yeah. And that's not the only part where that, like, this whole boss is just centered around making
you
fuck
yourself.
Oh, yeah,
there's one part in particular coming up that... Oh, yeah, this one's real evil.
Yeah.
Balance him with your own shots.
Yeah.
For some reason, I understood the gimmick with every other form of the boss, but this one I would always just lay into it and be wondering why it was bouncing around
bang,
so much.
Bang, bang. Yeah, he'll go absolutely crazy, and he just keeps gaining momentum the more you shoot him. But basically, you just want to kind of keep him away from you.
Yeah.
The best idea.
Oh, man.
Yeah, got to get cut a little close. Oh. Yeah. I was kind of shitting myself the whole anytime I was lined up with those blades. And now we just kind of relax.
I do let the screen. Yeah, you do.
That's right, you take it easy.
It's actually nice that the game doesn't kill you like every other game with auto-scrolling.
Yeah, like somehow other games you feel would manage to find a way to scroll you off screen and kill you somehow.
Well, this just scrolls you with it.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, I never knew you could actually get that high up.
Yeah, you can go pretty high in here. You can get some real bad angles on this part, too.
Yeah, wow, that was quick.
Yeah, her brake laser is pretty ridiculous. And whoop, I usually slide through that. I don't know why I jumped it.
And you just slide with the screen.
And here he's shooting missiles at me, but yeah, there.
Yeah, it's one of those real non-threatening parts of the auto-scroll.
But if Deadeye Joe is not in it, he won't fire the missiles.
Which is even weirder.
Yeah, it's real weird.
So this part is just completely not another good gravity jump there.
Yeah. And here's a part where I realize, wait a minute, this is not the side I'm usually on. So watch the little swag move I make up here.
Oh, no.
Whoop! Oh. There was a missile coming out, and the slide was enough to kill it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I slid through him and through a missile, and the missile died, thankfully. I was not feeling confident in that little jump, but I managed to pull it off.
Okay, so this is the form that I just completely...
You completely ripped this off.
Completely ripped it off in Project N 3-3.
Yeah.
So I was just like, hey, I'll do physics too, that's fun. And a lot of people like had trouble with that part, because it is kind of evil.
Yeah, well, yours goes side to side and is
it's not exactly the same, but yeah, just look at how much he'll wiggle when...
Yeah, he's got that wiggle motion down. he was all about waggle before Nintendo got on the scene.
Such a gimmick, this game. I know. Oh, look at we can rotate stuff.
Ooh.
Do you have to roll through that bottom claw, or do you just...
I don't think that you're...
Because you're just walking through the top one, or climbing through it.
Yeah, I think...
I think his body might hit you.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it would. I mean, maybe if he was to the side, but... Look at that. Another boss down! Look at all that explosion! All that pizza!
Okay, so now we're here with Deadeye Joe alive.
Yeah.
And I think you surrender for the route we're going on.
Maybe.
No, that leads... Yeah, because that leads to the train, I think.
Yeah, if you surrender, you go to the train. What I like about that, though, is like Deadeye Joe busts you out. I think that's pretty cool. I can carry on with my dark experiments! It looks like they changed his graphic here a little. Yeah, he's definitely taller here. Let's go! Fight to the end.
What do you say? I was wrong?
You were wrong.
I was wrong.
Absolutely wrong.
So is this stage 4 or does this still count as... is this 5 now?
Like, there's... I think this is stage 5. I think that, like, there was definitely a fade out. There was definitely stage clear.
Actually, it did say stage clear.
Yeah. So this is just a whole bunch of look what we can do. A lot of these things are very non-threatening.
I mean, some of them are just straight up jokes. Where...
yeah. Hell, one of them just gives you power-ups.
Yeah.
But, like, the combinations they make actually make sense.
It is kind of crazy, though, when you think, like, they made, like, 10 unique enemies just for the stage.
Yeah, it's so, pretty neat.
Just to do every combination. Because then they start doing, like, 3 at once, and then the final one is Fall 4.
Yeah. It's pretty neat. I like it. This guy can get a little out of hand every now and again. Depending on the kind of pattern he throws you. Because he can, like, throw the balls your way and then swoop your way. That's some bad news. You can slide through the balls. You'll barely get through, but you can do it. Then this guy...
what is this thing?
This guy is just like, hey, guy, spreading my seed everywhere. Look at him go, man. He's just pollinating everywhere.
The doctor's really small now, though.
Yeah, they changed.
I get that he's, like... he's sitting back a bit, but he just looks tiny up there. Yeah. Oh, and then this guy,
This guy is just like, here you go. You can have stuff. He can give you bombs, too.
A lot of stuff. Yeah. Beast thing and roly-poly guy.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle!
Whoop! Oh, that tail always fucks me up.
You gotta slide at the last second. Slide. Best thing in Contra game that they never brought back.
Well, what was it in
Hardcore Uprising? Has like air dashes and stuff, but
is there anything vaulting that makes you invincible?
Vaulting does. But vaulting is very hard to do.
I guess they don't do 3 at once, they just go right.
No!
Oh, fucking.
I'm just chilling out over
there. TVMA rating now.
Man,
this
boss really sucks without a laser.
Is this the stage 7 boss of Uprising?
It's very similar, but...
that's the same kind of thing where you have to be between the legs.
Yeah, it's very similar.
Unless you cheat and have a piercing laser.
Yeah.
Which makes it completely trivial.
Just completely trivial. Just like, whatever.
Oh, this stage. So this is like the only route where you actually meet your general guy again.
Yeah, it's the last time.
I always thought that was interesting. Every other route just goes right to the end game. This one has an extra stage.
Yeah, this is just like, hey, you like bosses?
We got some
of those.
If you like bosses, you're playing the right game.
You are definitely playing the right game, and you found yourself on the right. You found yourself definitely on the right route.
You know how I was saying earlier about how, like, there's a boss that inspired Wrecking Ball and then a boss that inspired a Project N 3-3 boss?
Yeah.
This boss here, I really wanted to do something similar in Project N 3-4. Just have, like, a stage 1 boss where there's 3 mini-bosses and then they all combine at the end of the stage.
And it's real neat. This thing can be way more annoying if you don't have a real badass laser. Because he can, like, shoot a tentacle up through the boat and, like, it's homed on your position and then it pulls back a little more just to fuck with you. And this guy could be real annoying.
Whoa.
Yeah, well, you gotta... That's a tight slide. You gotta do some tight sliding through this guy.
Oh, whoop. For some reason I didn't.
Look at that. Look how good I am. Look how good I am at sliding. I'm gonna do it again. I'm just gonna do it. Whoop. Right through him. I don't give no shit.
The physics of sliding on your little jet ski thing.
It makes no sense.
Makes no sense.
No sense at all. You're just running on it and propelling it forward. The slide is absolute silliness. And then I killed him in the air, which looks way better.
This didn't do hit damage and land on you.
That would have been pretty funny. I think I would have kept that death.
I guess this is the other thing from Stage 2 alternate, except doesn't it run in that one? The thing you're riding.
Yeah.
The second half of that stage has animation.
Yeah.
It's and the then same. They combine into Voltron.
Into big, dumb, retarded bot. I mean, what else do you call it?
This boss is... I think a lot of the endgame bosses really always screw me up because you just fight them less.
Yeah,
this guy in particular just has so many forms and attacks.
Yeah.
And there's just, like you said earlier...
And this attack, I love this attack. This is so
this
good.
Stage is Whoop. Just bosses. There are no actual enemies in it besides...
Yeah, it's just this guy. That's it.
Those three forms and then they combine.
Yeah.
After we just fought a stage of...
Of nothing but
combined
bosses.
Enemies.
Yeah.
For some reason, I thought the trainer was this route. I was wrong though.
The train's really good, though. I like the bosses and just the overall level design there. It's really tight, hard to get through. And
God,
really
this thing's so goofy looking.
I know! He's just gonna, like, spit at me, like, I'm barfing! What a very silly boss.
And just tons more. Look what we can do with
doing,
the old
doing, doing, doing. So good.
Yeah, gotta do those sound effects.
Doing.
Pew, 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 pew.
Oh my god. Come at me, bro! He's strutting his stuff, man. Let's do another combination.
Was this before or after Gunstar Heroes?
I think this was after.
Because, man, this boss really does seem like,
Seven
oh
force.
Yeah, oh yeah, well look what we'll do.
Yeah, basically. Yeah, this definitely feels like after. This guy's got a lot of attacks too. I wish he had lived long enough for me to show some more of them off because he's actually pretty
good. Was that it?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, that's it.
And then boom, swirly explosion.
So is this the one with the rocket at the end?
Yep.
Okay, that's this route.
And then just blow the door down with a kick.
And hey, it's a stage portion.
Hey, look. There's some guys. They pose resistance.
No, they don't.
No.
It's like Mario 1. You just can run through the entire game without stopping.
Yeah. And more.
God, this part.
More abject. And this is me. I'm like, God damn it, Crash Bomb. It's your time to shine. Let's go.
I forgot. This of all the goofy bosses in this game. This is the dumbest thing.
It's so stupid.
Ever done.
This is so stupid. This belongs in Gunstar Heroes.
Yeah, it really does. And then they fall over.
It's so stupid. And like the way they animate, they've got little frames of animation so that it looks convincing.
Man, video games are dumb. What happened?
I know.
You could never, ever... Could you imagine if a modern, like... if Gears of War had a boss like this?
I wish Gears of War had a boss like this!
Even then, just like, oh, look at this 3D-ish effect we can do.
Yeah. They don't care. They're just like, look, we're doing shit it's just all over the place. These effects are nuts. This is one of my favorite fights in the game, too. It's really unpredictable.
So this is not the one where you fight the Doctor on the space station?
No, that's a real fun little boss gauntlet, too.
Oh, you didn't agree.
I didn't agree because it game overs you.
I know.
It's a real bummer. You just gotta be like, you just gotta watch your spacing with this guy because it's just like, he can pull off any of his attacks at almost any time. This rock never comes close to hitting you, ever. If you ever get hit by it, you're bad.
It's really the Mizar fight of Genesis games.
Yeah, kind of. Just sliding through things feels so good.
Yeah, it really does.
Like, that should have hit me. That should have hit me.
You just said the rock never comes close to you, and then it, like, totally beamed you there, but you slid through it.
Yeah, I think the hitbox on it probably needs to be bigger for it to be a threat, because I think you can actually get by it by just, like, moving forward a couple pixels and laying down.
Man, even he blew up.
Yeah, everybody's gonna blow up, dude! is the best part of any Contra game. When things blow up. And I'm just like chilling, like,
whatever. The flames of hell,
she didn't give a shit. She's just like, whatever, I'm just rocking out. And of course, it's a Contra game. So we gotta have big old
soda, big old soda cans.
Yep, we gotta have soda cans. I wish my soda cans had fire coming out of them. And hey, it's our buddy, Dead Eye Joe. Final battle, the big climactic battle. Here we go. Alright.
I forgot about this one.
This is going to be very difficult.
Oh, jeez. I see what you're doing there.
Alright, later. I didn't even
Oh, that's
move.
A good explosion, though.
It really is.
And you can't help all up.
It's like, most games have, like, one or two canned animations that they do, but it feels like they did a different explosion configuration for nearly every enemy type.
I wonder if there was just one guy doing, like, math programming on explosions.
On explosions. Yeah, explosion tech. You know what part of the game is fun with a pea shooter? This one.
Well, they give you... You got one gun right there.
But if you're just doing a pea shooter run, let me tell you.
Who would do that?
I've done that.
Oh, jeez.
It's pretty fun.
Wait, what is really... this fucking rocket?
Yeah, I know. It's kind of gross.
How does it pop?
Hey, phallic imagery!
There's much less phallic imagery in this compared to Contra 3.
Yeah, it's a good point.
Which is, like, optics.
Yes. But this thing's just like, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're at the top of the missile. Only good things can happen up here. It's just like a big old worm, because I don't know. Why not? That seems like a thing an alien would be.
I like the two-frame animation of the legs in the background.
Yeah, it's really cool. Like, sometimes those, like, those little two-frame animations can work really well, because it makes it seem really skittery.
Yeah.
God, I love sliding. It's so good. Oh, man.
This boss is living longer than like 90% of the other ones.
Yeah, he really is. It's just by virtue of having a very small hitbox and a limited amount of time to hit.
Oh,
hey. It's like a...
Oh.
Hey, man, this is one attractive fella.
It's the Metallica cover.
Oh, God.
I actually like this boss just... The way the arms just keep coming out and being destroyed, like...
Yeah, it's...
real kind of nightmarish.
It really is. This is, like, probably, like, the closest we've been to body horror, because, like, if you look at this thing sprite real closely...
Oh, I think we're there, yeah. And then that thing. That phallic.
But you've got that one face on the left that's got
look at that thing.
That's got this part... the other part of the body just its mouth. Yeah. It's like, what the fuck is this?
It's very Resident Evil-ish.
Yeah.
Or maybe even like Splatterhouse or something.
Yeah, like John would love this.
It really does kind of stand out from everything else so
yeah,
far.
It's just...
Which are a lot of like bosses made out of geometric shapes, and then this thing has a super detailed, horrible sprite.
Yeah. It's not that difficult though. That's it.
Yeah,
he's
that
done.
First, really. I thought that lasted longer.
That's it. That's it. That is the longest route of Contra Shattered Soldier. Without deaths!
You mean Contra Hardcore?
I said Shattered Soldier.
Yep.
I do it every fucking time.
Hey, brother.
Hey, brother. Hello, brother. How's it going? Hey, Casey. How are you? 8 lives.
They don't give you much room for error on a 1 credit.
Nope. And off we go.
So what happens to that rocket when it lands and the aliens just come spilling out?
Yeah, like there's still aliens in there. They were crawling up the side of the fucking thing.
Man, I love Sonic 2.
Yeah.
the pilot is just Tails.
Hey, yeah. Sonic! Yeah. That'd be a good graphical edit there. Grab you some sprites.
And then upload it to... Actually, is this on Steam?
This?
Because, you know, there's all those Genesis games on Steam now.
This isn't a Sega-made game, right? This is a Konami game.
I know that, but I'm just like, so that is only Sega games. That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
No one else gives a shit about their back catalog.
Yeah. Like, if this was on Steam, I would have had it already. And
well, wait, because there's treasure games on Steam, though.
Yeah, but that game was published by Sega.
Okay,
there's Bike Man. There's Nice Guy and Bike Man. The two heroes of the Alien Wars. Akira Pito!
Boring
old package design. No bikes for you.
No.
Even back then, Konami wasn't nice enough to give us credit.
Do they really not? Like, every game does that.
Yeah, I know. Like, every game. And you. See you next mission.
Boy, just like Metroid.
Yep. Same verbiage.
Man, imagine this game with Samus.
Well, kinda. Right there. I beat it in under 3 hours. There you go. That good stuff. So that's some Contra hardcore. Flawless.
Why does the score go so high?
No,
like, there's two zeros at the front there that you clearly
you'll never
get.
You will never have a score that high. Ever. So,
because you can't loop, it seems.
No, you can't.
Yeah.
So that's Contra Hardcore.
Woo!
Go Contra.